He won't let you down.
And I know
he's
mine.
Oh yes, he is. Forever in my heart. So we gotta walk on. Walk on through temptation.
Oh, yes.
'Cause his love,
yes,
and his wisdom, oh, will be our helping hand.
I know the truth. And his words, they will be our salvation.
Oh.
And present to others our very own prophetess, Deborah.
Amen.
A woman who truly loves the Lord. Amen. When I first met her here, amen, you know, she was a mess. Amen. And she's still a mess, but in a better way and in a good way. Amen. You know, she came in broken and she's being healed, just as our name say, restoration. Amen. And she truly loves the Lord. Amen. And, you know, she's just on fire. She's just on fire for the Lord.
Amen.
So if you want an awesome word from the Lord, buckle your seatbelts. Amen. Kick off, I don't know how you're going to buckle your seatbelt and kick off your shoes. Amen. Because I know it's going to be a mighty word from the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. So after this song, the very next voice that you hear will be our very own prophetess, Deborah Williams. Amen. Amen.
To be thankful.
God have his way up in here, up in here, up in here. I want to thank God for raising me up this morning. And that he called out my name. There's a lot of Deborahs. But he called out Deborah Ann Williams.
Ann Williams.
Ann Williams. And she rose with a praise on her lips this morning.
Hallelujah.
And I want to thank my pastor, co-pastor, clergy, protocol, my friends that came out to support me this morning.
Hallelujah.
And just thank God for where I am.
Yes,
and thank God I'm yet still here. You know, a lot of people say, Deborah, how you doing? I said, Jesus is still on the
throne.
Praise
God. Yes.
So that means I got another chance.
Yes.
And another day.
Yes.
To get it right.
Yes.
And so when I thought about Pastor preached my sermon last Sunday, because that's my girl.
Amen.
The woman with the issue of blood.
Oh,
and I thought about the woman at the well, too.
Yeah.
And Pastor just straight, I was like, Lord Jesus.
Confirmation.
A woman with the issue.
Yeah. And so when I say, Pastor, you just preach my sermon.
It's all right.
But then, you know, God always have a word. He's always got a word. And when I thought about the woman at the well, he did see the best.
Yeah.
He sees the best in each and every one of us.
Yes, he does.
But in order to get the best, you got to be willing to give up some things.
Yes.
Because, see, you just can't keep stuff inside of you and expect for the best to come. come out.
Praise Jesus. Help us out this morning. So, the scripture that I thought about, the main scripture, is John 14:4. And he says, but whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst.
Never.
But the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life.
Yes.
So I'm going to come back and we're going to expound on that.
Yes.
But the woman at the well, who was she? She was a woman of ill repute. She was a street woman. She was a club, because I go to the club. Go to the club, get on down. Go to the club. And then I wonder why. She had five husbands. Well, check this out. That might have been her issue, but your issue might be some other things.
Amen.
Your issue might be some other things.
Yeah.
Lying, cheating, whoring, fornication. I'm just going to keep it real.
Amen.
I'm like, you know, I speaks what I see, Elder Lateef. When he said last week, pick some people up off the street and bring them up in here.
That's what I'm talking about.
So here we are. We all are somebody who was picked off a street somewhere and brought up in here.
Come on.
So when you think about the woman at the well, but Jesus said, I must needs go to Samaria, because he had a job to do. He wasn't just going there to be going. He said, I'm going to get me some prophetess, some evangelists, preachers, and teachers, and they tell me they're sitting by the well.
Yeah.
So when he went there, and I'm going to start from verse 1. It says, therefore, when the Lord knew that the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John, though Jesus himself did not baptize, but his disciples, he left Judea and departed again to Galilee. And verse 4 says, but he needed to go through Samaria.
That's right.
What happened if Jesus don't come to your Samaria? What happened if Jesus didn't come to your Samaria? What if we still be at the club, hanging out, lying, cheating, if he didn't come to your Samaria?
Yeah.
But the thing about it is he'll meet you right where you at.
Yes.
If you want to be met.
Yes.
See, if there's a condition, you know, Zion say, can I have lunch money? No, I take that back. She say, can I have an allowance? I said, but there's a condition with that allowance.
Amen.
It's a condition.
Yes, yes.
It's, if you want the allowance, you got to do some things to get it. Just ain't gonna give it to you all the time. So when he says, I must needs to go to Samaria, and it says, and you know, just born, it says, Jesus did not follow the usual way for Jews to travel between Galilee and Judea, which was to avoid Samaritan territory by crossing to the east bank of the Jordan River. You ever notice sometimes that we'll go a different route? Sometimes we gotta change up the way we do things.
Yes.
You know, I'm living in the era, I'm an old school grandma. So I believe in Rachel. Groom, whatever you get your hands on.
Yeah.
And people today, oh, we're gonna call the CPS because she's beating the children.
Oh.
I got beaten up standing right here. Because
right.
I got beat down.
Amen.
So when you look about this, when I begin to just look at the scriptures, they go much deeper than what we're talking about here.
Yes.
He chose a different route to go to Samaria.
Yes.
So when it says in verse 5, so he came to a city of Samaria, which is called Zychar, near the plot of the ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus therefore being weary from his journey.
Yeah.
You ever been weary from your journey?
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Amen.
You're tired. You be weary. And sometimes, you ever notice that we're running to people and you be so weary on the journey? But you know, we so uppity, Yvonne. We so uppity. She know what I'm talking about. We so uppity that I can't help you. You know, because I'm trying to get on my own journey. I'm about my own journey. But you know, a lot of times when we see people standing out there at the corner with the sign saying, I'm hungry. You know, Michael Jordan with all his millions say, why don't they go get a job?
Mm-hmm.
Well, with all your millions, you could have bought him a McDonald's. He'd have a job, he'd be chief CEO, and then he'd be helping some other homeless folks. See, we get caught up in about who we are sometimes and forget that the journey is about being God's business. So he got tired on that journey and he needed some water. Some water. Some people say water, and the ugly people say water. And some people say water. And some of them can just get a drink. But that drink, is it alcohol? Okay. Is it soda? Y'all wondering why this up here? I didn't stop at McDonald's and get no iced coffee, but that's one of my sins. Iced coffee. Every day, I go to a McDonald's and the lady know me. I said medium, she said medium iced coffee with 5 extra creams, half caramel, half hazelnut, Deborah. That's me. She know me. So when you get filled up with this, and I'm gonna get back to that, remember this. When you're filled up with this, and it's taking the place of water.
Yeah.
Taking the place of water.
Yeah.
So when Jesus said he was tired of the journey.
Yeah, come on.
So he gets to the journey, he says, sat by this well.
Uh-huh.
And it was about the 6th hour of the day.
Yeah.
So and it says, a woman of Samaria, but you know what I heard about the Samarians? And that they was half Jews, you know, there was issues there.
Oh, yeah.
They've been mixing up and carrying on.
Yeah.
Mixing up.
So they've been mixing up. So here she is, a woman of Samaria. That word woman, Pastor, ain't it lining up?
It's lining up.
That woman, a Samaritan, came to draw water.
Yeah.
And Jesus said to her, give me a drink.
Mm-hmm.
For his disciples had gone away into the city to buy food.
Uh-huh.
Again, I want y'all to remember the word woman. Remember that, if y'all know what I'm talking about, last week Pastor talked about, remember the word woman. Then the woman of Samaria, the woman of ill repute, the woman that used to hang out in the club, the woman that used to lie, the woman that was an adulteress, which is where she is, the woman that stood on the corner, the woman that smoked crack. She was representing all of us, y'all. The homosexual woman, the bisexual woman. I mean, it was all right there. Because, see, I have to take it out of context and not just talk about she had husband. Because all of us ain't got husbands. We got other sins.
Amen.
We got other sins. And you would be real with yourself.
Real.
You recognize your sin. And you know, we going to the church. Good morning. Hey, girl. Y'all notice I got these heels on because in a minute them flip-flops going to be on. But y'all notice when we go to church, big hat. We have an excuse me hat.
Problem.
That hat's so big, you come, excuse me. Then you stood in front of somebody and they can't even hear the word because your hat's so big.
Yeah.
Then you bust out in a mink coat and 90 degrees in San Antonio. Then you coming in church with the lashes. I couldn't put my lashes on this morning. I tried. We come in with the facade. We come in, we go to the well made up.
Yes.
You got the well made up. You can't get delivered.
Amen.
So when we come to church, we come here made up with the vicissitudes of sin.
Okay.
Okay?
Amen.
So we come here made up.
Mm-hmm.
And then when somebody wanna help you, you don't wanna get help. Cause then you're like, I'm having issues.
Mm-hmm.
Not me. You're talking to me? Yeah, you girl. You the one sitting on when then when the preacher gets to preaching, you just be crying. You be crying. And when he open up the door for you to come to the well, you want your food.
Amen.
Then you don't want the drink. Because you know when you leave here, you're going to go back and do what you were doing. I'm going to tell you about me. And my husband is right here, and thank you, Jesus, for 40 years. A brother didn't kill me, and I didn't kill him. Okay. I'm just keeping it real. See, because you know what? I can stand here and tell you about that word all day, but if I don't tell you something about why, what he's done for me,
right.
That brought me to this point right here.
Right.
Because he saw the best in me.
Yeah.
See, I came up in a broken home. I came up in domestic violence. I came up being the oldest, raising children. And so I had that dominance about me. My first husband married him, and he was crazy. He wanted me to ask him, could I go to the store? I was like, H to the no.
No.
Ask me, can. I was like, really, dude? So we got divorced. Then, May 12th, y'all listen. May 12th, 1976, I was at the NCO Club, Georgia Air Force Base. And that song was, you know, being my Marvin Gaye, I used to go out and party, oh, and I was getting it down. I was standing in the club, I was a lot smaller, I didn't got smaller again, but I was smaller then, I was fine. So me and my sister, we go to the club, and I was the best dancer. Oh, I be getting out there, stanking there, I was throwing them down. And then, Henry, Will, as he preferred to be called, he's standing at the bar, and he talking, and I was talking to somebody else. And then we got to talking. We met up. One thing led to another, it is what it is. Us is sin. Before us got married, we sinned. Okay? See, in order for you to get delivered, I got to tell you how he delivered me.
That's right.
Okay, so we met. May 12th was Mother's Day. May 31st, 1976. May 12th, 1976 was Mother's Day. Remember that? May 12th, 1976. We met. May 31st, 1976. That's about 3 weeks, right?
Yeah.
Us got married.
Got married.
So I was married now. We get married.
Amen.
But he don't really know that much about me, and I don't know that much about him. Because we moving on emotions and the lust of it all. I'm just keeping it real.
Keep it real.
Okay. So we meet, and we've been through. We both went outside the marriage. I think I stayed outside longer than he did because I was having fun. Club, doing whatever I wanted to do. We were pretty much married in name only. You ever been like that? See, when you get real, do you know and imagine how many men and women can get delivered from the well when they start drinking the rivers of living water? So when I look at now where he done met her at the well, and now he begins to tell her all about herself. In verse 10, Jesus answered and said to her, if you knew the gift. No, let me back up. Let me go back to 7. A woman of Samaria, remember that word woman. A woman of Samaria came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, give me a drink, for his disciples had gone away into the city to buy food. Then the woman of Samaria said to him, how is it that you, being a Jew, ask a drink from me, a Samaritan woman? For Jews have no dealings with Samaritans.
Right.
And isn't that what we do with one another? We don't have no dealings with one another. We don't want to get nobody help. We don't, because I think I'm better than you. Not. And Jesus answered and said to her, if you knew the gift of God, and who it is who says to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water. But let me go back up. Jesus did things out of the ordinary meeting her. First, women were considered greatly inferior to men. In public, no Middle Eastern man ever spoke to a woman, not even his wife, mother, or sister. One thing that Jesus went against. Second, no Jew ever spoke to a Samaritan. Jews believe Samaritans have betrayed their faith because they had intermarried with foreigners. She was a half-breed. And the Jews and the Samaritans hated and avoided each other.